Thank you. Good evening. Do we have a mic? Is that on? Yeah. Good evening. Thank you so much for being here. Happy holidays and happy Hanukkah. It is the first night of Hanukkah. Thank you for sharing that with us. We would like to now invite any choir alumni that would like to sing Carol of the Bells with us to start making their way down here. While I'm making one more announcement, we want to just recognize Marcus Tavani, who was left out of the program. He has been interning, and Matt Bethune has been the director, but he's not here, and Marcus is doing all this work. And so, Marcus, thank you, and we're sorry you're not, oh my gosh, look at you guys, not in the program. No more alum? Okay, this will be conducted this year by this year's student director, Mr. Christopher Fitting.
Dashing through the snow in a wonderful song we sang. O'er the fields we go, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride.
Ding, 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 ding.
O'er the fields we go, o'er the fields we go.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Ding, 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 ding.
Our newest group, which is our intermediate women's choir. We've been fortunate with this 8-period day this year to sort of separate the groups, so we're actually rehearsing together. It's an awesome thing, let me tell you. And this is our new intermediate women's group, and they're going to sing Christmas Dawns Again for you as soon as we get settled here.
Sing a song of cheer, sing.
Tracy, and I'm a euphonium and trombone player in the concert band. Before you are the members of one of our concert bands. Our first piece tonight is Pulse, and it was written by Randall D. Standridge. It uses a minimalistic and pointillistic writing to create a tapestry of rhythm and color. Inspired by artists such as Charles Zurette and Charles Ingrand, the unrelenting rhythm depicts the constant sharp motions of a painter's brush. Each note, a point of the color on the canvas. It was originally part of a larger work entitled Artisms, and was premiered in 2010 at the College Band Directors National Association in New Mexico.
Hello, my name is Deanna Moskowitz, and I am a freshman percussionist with the concert band. Our next piece, Down a Country Lane, originally appeared in Life magazine in 1962. It is a solo piano work for young students, written by one of America's most famous composers, Arno Copland. Copland explained that the title is descriptive only, not imaginative. The title itself was attached to the piece only after it was finished. The transcription for the wind band was completed in 1988. And evoked high praise for the composer himself.
Thank you. My name is Amanda Zweibel. I am the string bassist for Concert Band. Folk and popular songs are a vital part of our culture and have always reflected the tastes and interests of the time period that they are associated with. American Folk Rhapsody No. 3, written by Claire Grunemann, is a part of a set of four fresh, interesting treatments to American folk songs. Songs that have persisted throughout our history as a nation, including Our Colorado Trail, Get Along Little Doggies, the poignant ballad Careless Love, and the lively and more familiar classic barn dance tune Turkey in the Straw. The Rhapsody closes with a reprise of Careless Love interspersed with other songs.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Before I introduce our fourth speaker, I wanted to thank you all for coming on out tonight to our winter concert. My name is Justin McAdams. I am the band director here at Phoenixville High School. Very happy to be here. Very happy to see all of you here. We hope you are enjoying the concert. I'm going to turn it over to our fourth and final speaker for this ensemble. So, Ben.
Hello.
Hello. There you go.
Hello, my name is Ben Levine, and I am a senior bass clarinetist in the band. Our final selection for this portion of the concert is David Holsinger's Gathering at the Ranks of Hebron. In the Old Testament, Hebron was the capital city that King David chose to rule from. It is a city that appears many times throughout those texts. The inspiration for this composition comes from the biblical story of 350,000 men who came together armed for battle in defense of David. This eventually led to the first ill-fated attempt at bringing the Ark of the Covenant back to Jerusalem. We hope you have enjoyed this portion of the concert.
Thank you.
much to Alice Poverty and our student Amanda Zwiebel for, she's in like every group here tonight, and just excellent. This is a product of our new string program that we have in this district, and we're already seeing it come to life and on stage, so thank you so much. After this next piece, we're going to have a quick 10-minute intermission. Just a quick reminder that you can't bring any food or drinks back in here, so buy things that you can eat fairly quickly, but buy a lot of them, obviously. Just eat them fast. And we're going to make what is the worst musical transition I've ever done in my life. We're going to go from 18th century Elgar to Candy Cane Lane, and then you can enjoy your intermission.
kein Lupo.
Say it to the heart, little shame on it.
one who wants can cuddle and care. I only want the world for Christmas, the blue-green forever turning world for Christmas. To restore, to repossess, please make it last. My fate is in your hands. Oh, give me a present for the future. You could follow your heart, but you follow a whim and fill up your stocking.
Thank you. ox and lamb kept time, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum.
And the concert band. Before you, you have the members of the second concert band. And the first piece of this portion of the concert is called Dedicatory Overture. It is a traditional concert overture written by one of the mid-20th century's leading wind band composers, Clifton Williams. He was the initial recipient of the American Bandmasters Association's Ostwald Prize, a composition competition originated in 1956. And given annually to the year's best new work composed for band. This piece, which was written in 1964, was commissioned by Evansville College in Indiana for the dedication of their new music building, and draws upon the college's alma mater. And now, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I present to you Dedicatory Overture.
Thank you.
One, two, there we go. Thank you very much. Before our next speaker comes up, I just wanted to kind of explain the two bands that you're seeing on stage. One we are calling Concert Band Purple, one we were calling Concert Band White. By the luck of the draw, it's actually not a top band or a second band or a low band or a high band or anything. It's actually two pretty evenly matched ensembles. So that's why you're seeing two entirely different programs here. So I will turn this over to our next speaker, who is... I want to make sure we got this. Here we go. You're on up.
I'm short. I'm sorry.
It's the comedy routine up here. Here.
It's because I'm short, isn't it? Thank you, Mr. McAdams. Hi, everybody. My name is Ray Jacobs, and I am a junior in the band, and I play the tuba. Our next piece is titled Starlight and was commissioned by the Starlight Band of Tulsa, Oklahoma. It evokes the images of nighttime on the plains of the Midwest. The composer, David Gorham, is the director of bands at Owosso High School in Oklahoma, a position he has held since 1989. The Owosso bands are considered to be one of the top programs in the country, having performed in the Tournament of Roses Parades, Bands of America, national competitions, and the Midwest Band and Orchestra Clinic. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Zach Lindley, and I'm a sophomore trumpet player in the band. Our third piece tonight is Daydream, written by Timothy Marr. It was written on a request to the composer to be used as a quiet tune for the 1989 St. Olaf College Festival of Bands. It is intended to be introspective, eliciting mood changes and shifting images through different tone colors and sound palettes. It is the composer's intention to conjure up the audience's mind the feeling when he or she awakes from that daydream and returns to reality.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Before we play our final piece here, I do have a couple of thank yous that I would like to give out. First off, to all of you, again, for sitting through the marathon tonight. We hope that you're enjoying it. I also have to thank a couple of students on stage as well. And some of you are here, and some of you are out there listening. But if you've been doing double, triple, quadruple, or quintuple duty tonight, running back and forth with costume changes and sort things of that nature, could you stand up now? And if you're out there as well. You saw Bruce and Danielle earlier in Vocal Fusion, and how many costume changes have you guys had tonight? Two, give or take. He's like, we were tuning and he's running and jumping over the horn section to get into here, so thank you guys. Really nice job. I really appreciate it. I have also one recognition I would like to acknowledge everyone tonight. We do have one student who has actually made district band and district orchestra representing Phoenixville in the District 12 festivals, and actually is sitting first chair overall both in the band and the orchestra. So Mr. Donnie Jackson, would you please stand up? Cool. And we'll turn this over to our final speaker of the evening.
Hi, my name's Kaylee Horton, and I play tenor saxophone and bari saxophone. Our final piece tonight is Stephen Reneke's Into the Raging River. Into the Raging River is a programmatic tone poem inspired by whitewater rafting trip on the Goli River in the mountains of West Virginia. The piece takes us through various stages of the trip, the opening, sunrise, and the excitement of the initial entry into the river, and the calmness of the backwater pools. The river continues as we finally approach the rapids, leading up to the final obstacle, a 13-foot class 4 waterfall. The finale of the piece portrays the exhilaration as we heroically plunge over Sweet Falls, ending our journey on the water.
Thank you.
you so much. Thank you really for being here. I know this is getting a little bit late, and the five-year-olds and the three-year-old. Are you doing okay? Okay, cool. Well, she can do it, you all can do it, so. thank you for taking time out. I know this is a busy time of year. One little piece of business. If you purchased a poinsettia, they are up here. They are, I think they're labeled, but I'm assuming Sharon Bauer will be here to help hand them out. And they are labeled, okay. So please come get them at the end. We could probably open that curtain anytime. Who else do we need to thank? Thank all these students. I'm waiting for the curtain to open, and I can't tap dance right now. Thank you so much to Marie Anderson, our accompanist. And thank you to all of you for encouraging your students to participate in music. I know for many of these kids, this is the place that they shine, and they don't have a whole lot of other places they shine in, and I think they shine beautifully, and I hope you think so too. So. Curtain issue? Okay. Okay, cool. So, yay. Okay, we're going to do one more combined number here. We are going to sing an arrangement of Sleigh Ride. Also, thank you so much to Mr. McAdams. This is his first year here, and he's only been here a few months, and amazing, amazing, the sound of the man. Really beautiful. So. And we all know how hard it is to be the new person, and he's just doing great. So thank you, Mr. McAdams. Hi. Okay, we're ready. Sleigh Ride.
Just move a little bit, JJ. Gotta move.